shall we finish this bathroom remodel? So you would think when you do a bathroom remodel that probably the worst thing has got to be the demo. I mean, there is a lot of hard work breaking through tile, dealing with cast iron tubs, a lot of hard work in demo of a bathroom. Or maybe it's the tiling process when you're rebuilding, because dang, there's a lot of tiling when you're doing a bathroom. No, not with our bathroom. That wasn't the worst part. Of course not. It had to be something that was normally a pretty easy thing. Did you ever read the story about Goldilocks and the Three Bears? Well, that's kind of like what we went through when it came to the walls of our bathroom. So, we needed to texture the drywall portions of the wall. In other words, the exposed wall that doesn't have tile on it. When you're not expert drywallers, there's going to be imperfections. You can see possibly some of the seams. So you texture to hide all of that. Texture can be done a couple of different ways. We were going to do a spray texture using what's called a hopper gun, which it attaches to a compressor. When you do that kind of texture, you have got to protect everything. I mean, you got to drape sheets of plastic over anything that you don't want texture on, because it's going to go everywhere. It takes a lot of time to do that, but once we had it all prepped, Novablotz went in there to start spraying the texture on the walls, only to find that the hopper gun just did not want to cooperate. It wouldn't spray consistently, the trigger on it would get stuck and spray too much, huge glops of joint compound in essence, the wall texture was streaming out of the top of it and landing on his head. Oh, it was a disaster. Just horrible. So before it could even dry, we had to scrape it all off and go back to the drawing board. We decided, okay, let's scrap the hopper gun because it's a piece of crap. He couldn't get it to work correctly. He tried taking it apart, nothing helped. We decided we'll try roll-on texture, another technique. You just use a certain kind of paint rollers, in essence, and you roll it on. So we tried that. We rolled on texture. And it looked like it would be okay. Now understand, we'd already textured the walls once, so it already had a white cast on it from the first round of texture. And then you roll on texture, so it's all very white. Then, you can't really tell what the texture's gonna look like until you paint it, unfortunately. And here's the other mistake I made. When I picked out the paint color for our living room, it's a color called Buckskin Pony, I did sample boards. I moved them around the room. I looked at them at different times of the day. How does the light affect them? Until I was sure I liked the color. It had been so long on this bathroom remodel, I just didn't want to deal with that. This is a small little space. I decided to trust the paint chip. It's only paint. And I went with a color called Mica. What we were shooting for was a very, very light slate gray. You know, so kind of a bluish gray color. Well, we picked this color called Mica, we painted it on, not only in there, but in the little hallway outside of the bathroom, which was still white. And after it dried, no. First of all, it was way too blue. It looked like it would be great for little boys' room. Perfect. But it just didn't, well, it looked great with what was going to be my countertop, which is called Blue Pearl. It really wasn't what I wanted. It wasn't what I was going for. So we thought, okay. How can we salvage this? Let's try doing a glaze technique over top of it. That's where you take some pigment, paint color, and glaze, and you wash it over the walls, and it tints the walls slightly. I did four sample boards with different ratios of pigment to glaze. And to be honest, it really just made the walls look, on the sample boards, it just made them look dirty. It wasn't what we wanted. Okay, well that wasn't gonna fly, so we decided we'll just repaint the walls. So we went back, checked out some more colors, picked up samples of two colors. One was more gray, one was more blue. Did sample boards, looked at them. We weren't super excited about either color, but we decided to go with the more blue one, Jackrabbit. It was the next color down in value from the Mica color that we'd originally used. The main problem was that it was darker, but we thought maybe it'll be okay. So we repainted everything, the bathroom and the hallway, with Jackrabbit. Okay, second paint color, and now two textures done. And every time I went into that bathroom and looked, I just wasn't happy. Poor Novablotz, he'd already installed all the finish as far as the shower rods and the towel bars and the toilet paper holder you know, the covers over the outlets and everything, but every time I went into the bathroom, I was like, oh, I could see a couple of the seams, and there were places where it was, you know, too sparse or too heavy. Roll-on texture is just really not a great solution. And I really wasn't that happy with the paint color because it really was dark, very dark. So No Fur Blots and I discussed it, and we decided, okay, we'll try one more time. My original plan had been to do a knockdown technique in the bathroom. This is where you apply the wall texture with either a brush or your hands or a couple of different ways, and then you take a trowel and you scrape it so that you knock down the high points. And I did sample boards. I did many sample boards of that. And we decided on a particular one. We thought this was the one to go with. It was a hand slap and then knockdown technique. Plus, we decided on a new paint color that was going to work out. I think we chose a color called Silverware. I tried out three new colors, and we settled on one called Silverware. Well, the morning, or the night before I was to texture the bathroom, I couldn't sleep. I was agonizing over this. I was so worried about it. I was the one that was going to have to do this. When you're doing something like this, really the same person has to do the whole texture for it to be consistent. And although we could take down the towel bar, we did take down the towel bars and the shower rod and the toilet paper holder, at this stage of the game, the vanity and the sink and the faucet had already been installed, and I couldn't really remove those. Working around this faucet, and you'll understand when you see the photo, working around this faucet was not going to be easy trying to do this knockdown technique. And the more I thought about it, the more worried I got. Plus, I mean, I was having to deal with 8-foot tall walls, and I'm not tall. So we talked about it. We said, you know what? Skip it. Let's just go buy a new hopper, a better hopper, and we'll go back to the spray technique instead. So that's what we did. We went back to the hardware store, bought a nicer, more professional quality hopper, recovered everything again with plastic on everything, including now the nice new the vanity, countertop, sink, faucet, all that. And No Fur Blots went in there and sprayed with the new hopper. That time it worked out pretty good. We did a few little touch-ups with the spray can to catch a few places where it was kind of sparse, but worked a whole lot better. And once that was done, we could finally repaint, and we gave it, like I said, this coat of Silverware, but only in the bathroom. After painting the hallway, the various blues we'd tried up to that point, I really didn't like how either of them looked right next to the buckskin pony that's in the foyer. And the walls actually touch. I mean, they come together like this. And so there's, you know, buckskin pony here, and there was going to be blue here. And I just didn't like how they came together. So we decided we'll just bring the buckskin pony into the hallway. And finally, after three attempts at texture and three paint colors, we got it done. Like I said, Goldilocks and the Three Bears. The first one was too hot, the second one was too cold, the third one was just right. We had to reinstall the shower rod, the towel bars, the toilet paper holder. And then the only other little hiccup we had was when I had the guy build the vanity as part of this barter deal, I had him build a shelf tower that was going to sit on top of the countertop just to maximize my storage. But once we actually put it up there, it looked terrible. It made the bathroom look really small. This is stained a very, very dark color. That was the other downside to this. I wanted a dark cherry like I have in the kitchen, and what I got was really more of an espresso color. Not really what I wanted, but okay. But this really dark shelf tower up high just made the bathroom feel like it was closing in on you. And so we decided, you know what, skip it. And instead, I found online these little brackets that will hold a glass shelf. And I had some glass actually cut and shaped locally for a little, you know, pie slice kind of shelves, a couple of them over in the corner where the shelf tower was originally going to go. So anyway, this whole part of it was the worst part. You wouldn't think so. Check out the photos. Tell me what you think. All right, so this is after our first two attempts at texture. The plastic was still up, partially just around the tub area, but this was after we had sprayed the first round, scraped that off, and then rolled on the second round of texture. We removed all the plastic except for around the tub because we wanted to install, ooh, what's that? The vanity. This is after the first attempt at painting. On the left, you see the little paint chip mica and a close-up view of the wall. Over on the right, you see the hallway looking into the bathroom. You see how it really looks more light blue there? So back to the drawing board. Here you see my sample boards. The top one there shows my different attempts at coming up with a wash technique, and none of them really worked. And the bottom sample board shows the two new colors we were trying out. The Woodlawn Silver Brook really had a kind of a greenish cast, so we went with the Jackrabbit, but it is kind of dark. And now here's the bathroom and the hallway with their second coat of paint, Jackrabbit. Look at the mess. I hate doing construction projects. So about the same time, our plumber came in to install our fixtures. On the left, you see my new sink and faucet on the vanity, and on the right, you see the tub spigot and control switch. Well, that control switch became a huge problem. Turns out the guy who supplied me these fixtures gave me the wrong valve, the part that goes in the wall behind the control. So we had to have the plumber come back out and remove the old one. So here you go, nice big hole in the wall on the opposite side so we don't damage the tile work we just did. That way the plumber could cut out the old one, put in a new one, and we end up paying literally twice as much for what was a free valve. So we decided we were going to redo the walls. We also decided to add a exhaust fan with a light. So in order to do that, Nofer Blantz had to open up just a little bit of the wall where we originally had just a receptacle so he could add the new switch. Eventually he had to change that again because we decided we wanted the light to be on its own switch from the fan. But you can see how he opened it up. And here are my several sample boards at different kinds of texture. It's kind of hard to make it out in the video, but each one is very different. And it was all for naught because we decided not to go with any of these kind of texture techniques after all. So back to using the spray texture. Now you can get an idea of just what kind of protection you have to give it when you're going to do spray texture. Everything has to be protected, including the opening to the bathroom itself. You can see on the left our little makeshift door, and on the right you see where the vanity and faucet is, and you can see how we had to tape over the switches and outlets. Now this is looking the other direction. You can see on the left there's the rest of the medicine cabinet. We had to remove the sconces, protect the other switch box, and on the right you see we removed the towel bar and the toilet paper holder. All that had to go away, and everything get protected again with plastic. Was it worth it? Well, you tell me. Over on the left, you see the photos from the original bathroom, and on the right, you see the photos from the new bathroom. I think it looks a little bit better, don't you? And here's another shot so you can see the vanity and the toilet in the back of the tub area, our little niche that we built in. Again, I think it looks a whole lot better now than it did before. Okay, did you like it? I'm actually pretty pleased with it. I'll do one more video next week, like I did with the kitchen, where I talk about the good and the bad. What I liked, what I don't like, what would I have done differently if I had it to do all over again. That's all for now. See ya.
See ya.